students of standard 10. In geography, you are learning about water resources. Today you are going to learn chapter 5, water resources, part 3. In this part 3, you are going to learn about irrigation. Why is there need for irrigation and irrigation potential in India? As India is an agricultural country and population is increasing day by day, demands are also increasing. So, India needs to grow more and more crops in different seasons. As it is monsoonal country, it receives rainfall during few months and rest of the months they cannot grow if there is no irrigation facility. So, India needs irrigation. What do you mean by irrigation? Irrigation is the artificial application of water to ground. To grow more, farmers can utilize fertilizers, hybrid varieties of seed, and can be utilized as modern fertilizers and machineries. For that, in different seasons, they should need irrigation facility. And therefore, India needs irrigation facility. And there are many reasons. That is why India needs irrigation. First is seasonal rainfall. Second, uncertain rainfall. And third, uneven distribution of rainfall. Fourth, erratic rainfall. All these different points are given for the India's monsoonal rainfall or seasonal rainfall. India receives seasonal rainfall, which is erratic in nature, which is uncertain. Sometimes it comes in time, sometimes delays, sometimes it brings flood, very heavy rainfall occurs, sometimes there is drought conditions. It is distributed all over India unevenly. Like northeast of India receives very heavy rainfall. The western coast of India and peninsular India receives very heavy rainfall. And the interior receives less rainfall. And the parts of Rajasthan receives very little rainfall. So like this uneven distribution of rainfall, if there is, farmers cannot grow more and more crops. So, in the drier region where there is less rainfall, they have to utilize rivers or artificial water reservoirs for their irrigation to grow more and more crops. So, as India receives seasonal rainfall only for 4 months or few months, other rest of the months are dry. To grow crops and vegetables, India needs irrigation. If we see other points, cultivation of certain crops. Some crops need good rainfall and sufficient amount of water. If there is less water, they cannot be grown properly. Like rice, jute, cotton, sugarcane, they need water facilities throughout the year. During rainy season, there is good rainfall and abundant water. But they mature or get matured in 9 months or 10 months. So, they need irrigation as India is a hot country. So, the next point is the hot climate. India receives tropical monsoon climate. There is hot climate because the southern part lies in the tropical zone and northern part is lying in the subtropical zone. So it has high temperature. There is high rate of evaporation. So during the dry months, when the surface water bodies are dry, there should be sufficient water to irrigate and to cultivate some crops. So as India has hot climate, there should be irrigation facility. Next point is Green Revolution program. When Green Revolution started in Europe, Europeans started in India too. And when it came and started, hybrid varieties of seeds were started to be sown. Too much amount of fertilizers were also started to be utilized. And to grow more and more, farmers started to use more and more water. And for that, irrigation is very essential to grow, to fulfill the demands of increasing population. So, there is need for irrigation because of seasonal, uncertain, uneven and erratic nature of rainfall in India. To cultivate some of the crops which need good or sufficient rainfall. There is hot climate and due to Green Revolution program, India needs irrigation facility. There is irrigation potential in India because of perennial rivers. If you look at the map of India, there are many perennial rivers rising from the great Himalayan ranges, which is in the northern part of India. Because glaciers provide water throughout the year, these rivers like River Ganga, Yamuna, Gomti, Ghagra, Koshi all receive good amount of water throughout the year. And therefore some canals are constructed and they provide water throughout the year. So there is high potentiality in northern part of India because of River Indus and River Ganga and their tributaries which are perennial. Second is the low level land. A large Indus Ganga plain and Ganga Brahmaputra plain is good and fertile as it has very good fertile alluvial soil and the area is flat, and therefore construction of canals or digging well is very easy and good means of irrigation in India. Third is reservoir of groundwater. In northern India, there is high water table and therefore if water reservoir or wells are dug, there farmers can get easily water. So, reservoir of underground water are also always perennial. Site for constructing dams. In peninsular India, there are uneven terrain of land due to the presence of mountains and plateaus. And they provide good site, excellent site for the construction of dams. And the natural hollows in this plateau region are also providing depressions in which rain water can be collected and can be utilized in drier period. So that can be also utilized for irrigation. And therefore, India has large irrigation potential because of perennial rivers, low level land, reservoir of groundwater, site for constructing dams. Thank you.